I'd like to introduce Kostas Papadakis, I apologise for my pronunciation at any point, who is one of the prosecuting lawyers of the trial against Golden Dawn happening in Greece at the moment. He is also a member of Andasia, and he's going to be translated by Demetrios, who's a member of Tottenham branch. So, without further ado, thank you, Kostas.
Φίλες και φίλοι, καλησπέρα. Είναι πολύ μεγάλη τιμή για μένα το γεγονός ότι βρίσκομαι εδώ στο Λονδίνο για να εκφράσω και μέσα από αυτό το βήμα τον αγώνα που κάνουμε στην Ελλάδα ενάντια στο φασισμό.
Friends and comrades, welcome. First of all, welcome. It's an honor to be here to speak to you all about what's happening in Greece and about fascism there.
Και για την τιμή αυτή ευχαριστώ το SWP που μου έκανε την χάρη να με καλέσει για να έρθω μαζί σας. Ζητώ συγγνώμη που τα αγγλικά μου δεν είναι αρκετά για να μιλήσω στη γλώσσα σας και θα σας κουράσω λίγο με τη μετάφραση.
Thank you to the SWP giving me the invitation to come and speak to you and apologies for my English not being well enough to speak to you in your own language and it's going to be tiring listening to me as interpreting.
Όταν ήμουν νεότερος, βλέπετε, προτιμούσα να πηγαίνω στις διαδηλώσεις από το να μαθαίνω αγγλικά και να τα αποτελέσματα.
As a young person, I wasted my time on demonstrations rather than learn English.
Ευχαριστώ. Λοιπόν, να έρθω στο θέμα τώρα. Θα ξέρετε όλοι ότι η Χρυσή Αυγή το 2012 για πρώτη φορά πέτυχε ένα καλό εκλογικό αποτέλεσμα και εκπροσωπήθηκε στην Ελληνική Βουλή.
To start with, we start with 2012 when Golden Dawn managed to have a breakthrough in the elections and for the first time had MPs elected to Greek Parliament.
Τα προηγούμενα χρόνια από τότε η Χρυσή Αυγή ήταν μια πολύ μικρή συμμορία τραμπούκων η οποία χτυπούσε, δολοφονούσε και τραμπούκιζε γενικότερα απεργούς νεολαίους και εργάτες.
Previous to 2012, Golden Dawn was a tiny organization that went around the streets beating up people, killing and basically doing thuggish activities in the streets.
Η εξέλιξή της σε κοινοβουλευτικό κόμμα και η μαζικοποίησή της υπήρξαν αποτέλεσμα σχεδιασμένης στήριξης από τις αστικές πολιτικές δυνάμεις και κυρίως από τη Νέα Δημοκρατία στην προσπάθειά τους. Η λαϊκή δυσαρέσκεια που στην Ελλάδα υπήρξε πάρα πολύ έντονα και υπάρχει τα τελευταία χρόνια λόγω των μνημονίων να μην οδηγήσει τον κόσμο στην αριστερά, αλλά στην ακροδεξιά.
The growth of Golden Dawn was a conscious plan by the right-wing government at the time that saw the economic crisis coming up and they were concerned that people did not move to the left and therefore push for Golden Dawn to rise and become a mass movement.
Με ένα πολύ σχεδιασμένο τρόπο παρουσίαζαν οι δυνάμεις του καταστημένου τη Χρυσή Αυγή ως δήθεν αντίπαλό τους, έπειθαν τον κόσμο για αυτό και η Χρυσή Αυγή με τη σειρά της προσπαθούσε να πείθει τον κόσμο ότι για την κρίση δεν φταίνε οι καπιταλιστές αλλά φταίνε οι ξένοι οι μετανάστες, οι εργάτες και οι απεργοί και έστρεφε προς τα εκεί τις προσπάθειές της.
It was well-planned that they consciously pushed to show that Golden Dawn was an opposition organization and it had it carried the message that for everything that was wrong in the Greek economy, the fault was not that of the ruling class and the establishment, but for everything, the people should be blaming immigrants and immigration.
Yeah. Ένα χρόνο και περισσότερο από το 2012 που η Χρυσή Αυγή μπήκε στη Βουλή, οι συμμορίες της τραμπούκιζαν στους δρόμους της Αθήνας, πολλές φορές με ζωντανή τηλεοπτική κάλυψη, χωρίς να ενοχλούνται από αστυνομία και δικαστήρια.
For a whole year after 2012, Gold and Dawn and their street thugs were free to roam around the streets, beating people up, sometimes with live coverage by television, and they were not prosecuted or had any fear of the police intervention.
Θα πω για παράδειγμα ότι άπειρες φορές έχουν μεταδοθεί τηλεοπτικά περιστατικά όπου τα τάγματα εφόδου της Χρυσής Αυγής διώχνουν μετανάστες μικροπολιτές και τους πετάνε τα πράγματα από τους δρόμους και είναι μαγαζιά, απειλούν, χτυπάνε κόσμο, εμποδίζουν θεατρικές παραστάσεις, βρίζουν αστυνομικούς χωρίς να τους ενοχλεί κανένας ή απελευθερώνουν κρατούμενους από αστυνομικές κλούβες.
Just to give some of the numerous examples that often they were portrayed on television, shown to beat up in the streets. Immigrants break up their little stalls where they were selling to make a living. They were insulting the police, breaking up a theater by left-wing shows, and even one case, they released somebody arrested by the police. They went and just released them free.
Η ανοχή της αστυνομίας και του κράτους τους αποθράσινε σε τέτοιο σημείο ώστε να φτάνουν πλέον κάθε μέρα, τα βράδια, να κάνουν επιθέσεις σε γειτονιές μεταναστών και ειδικότερα το καλοκαίρι του 2013, το Σεπτέμβριο, έφτασαν μέσα σε μία εβδομάδα αφενός να κάνουν μία δολοφονική επίθεση ενάντια σε συνδικαλιστές του ΚΚΕ που κολούσαν αφίσες στο πέραμα και λίγες μέρες αργότερα να δολοφονήσουν τον Παύλο Φίσα.
The tolerance of the police to all these activities by Gold and Dawn allowed them to get more and more bold, and their attacks grew and grew. Until in September 2013, there was a murderous attack against Communist Party activists, and a few days later, the killing of Pavlos Fissas and his murder.
Το χρονικό σημείο αυτό, ευτυχώς, σήμανε την αφύπνιση του αντιφασιστικού κινήματος, το οποίο και στην Ελλάδα και στο εξωτερικό κατέκλυσε τους δρόμους και άρχισε να δημιουργεί όρους αντίστροφης κίνησης στα πράγματα.
This event was a wake-up call for the left that took them seriously, started organizing against them and growing the movement to oppose them.
Η κυβέρνηση αναγκάστηκε να εγκαταλείψει την ανοχή και να προχωρήσει σε συλλήψεις και σε προφυλάκηση των ηγετικών στελεχών της Χρυσής Αυγής και όλων όσων είχαν σχέση με τη δολοφονία του Φίσα.
After that, the government was forced to take steps, and that they eventually led to arrest of Gold and Dawn and prosecute those responsible for the murder of Pavlos Fissas.
Μόνο που οι προθέσεις της κυβέρνησης του Σαμαρά απέναντι στη Χρυσή Αυγή δεν ήταν οι ίδιες με αυτές με τις προθέσεις του κινήματος.
Except the motives of Samara's government were different from those of the movement.
Η ανησυχία της κυβέρνησης του Σαμαρά ήταν ότι ανέθρεψε ένα σκυλί για να επιτίθεται στους εργάτες και αυτό το σκυλί κάποια στιγμή το είδε να χυμάει εναντίον της κυβέρνησης.
For Samara's government, what worried them was that they had a bulldog. They trained a nasty dog to attack the working class, and they slowly realized that it was turning against them as well.
Με λίγα λόγια, η Χρυσή Αυγή είχε φτάσει στο σημείο να διεκδικεί πια ηγετικό ρόλο στις πολιτικές εξελίξεις της Ελλάδας.
In other words, Gold and Dawn had grown to such a size that it began to challenge for greater role in developments in Greek politics.
Παρ' όλα αυτά, ο Σαμαράς δεν έχανε την ευκαιρία ακόμα και τότε να ταυτίζει τους ναζιστές με την αριστερά και με όσους τάσσονταν ενάντια στη συμμετοχή της Ελλάδας στο ΝΑΤΟ, στην Ευρωπαϊκή Ένωση και στο Ευρώ.
Even then, Samaras did not stop equating those opposing the fascists and putting them together, that the left was the same as the fascists, and anyone who opposed NATO, opposed Euro and the Euro and Europe, for Samaras were as bad as Golden Dawn.
Είναι γνωστή στην Ελλάδα η θεωρία των δύο άκρων που τα επικοινωνιακά επιτελεία της άρχουσας τάξης χρησιμοποιούν τα τελευταία τρία χρόνια και με αυτήν προσπαθούν να ταυτίζουν τον αντικαπιταλιστικό χώρο με τους ναζιστές προκειμένου να δίνουν δόξα στους ναζιστές και να συκοφαντούν τον αντικαπιταλιστικό χώρο.
In Greece, it's well known the theory of two extremes where the mass media, they equate the far left with the fascists and present them as being the same thing, two sides of the same coin.
Και τα λέω αυτά για να γίνει αντιληπτό ότι δεν υπάρχει καμία βαθιά αντίθεση ανάμεσα στις καθεστωτικές πολιτικές δυνάμεις και στη Χρυσή Αυγή και αυτό έχει σχέση και με τη δίκη που γίνεται σήμερα στην οποία αμέσως μετά θα αναφερθώ.
Okay, this is to show that as far as the politics are concerned, that pretty much behind the fascists, behind Golden Dawn, is the ruling class, and this has implications with regards with the trial that is going on at the moment, in which I'm going to refer now.
Η Χρυσή Αυγή υποστηρίζει παντού ότι η δίωξή της γίνεται για πολιτικούς λόγους χωρίς να υπάρχουν στοιχεία, αλλά η πραγματικότητα είναι αντίθετη.
Golden Dawn insists that the trial is political without any evidence, but reality is completely different.
Και συγκεκριμένα πρώτα απ' όλα η Χρυσή Αυγή δεν διώκεται με τις διατάξεις για τρομοκρατική οργάνωση όπως θα συνέβαινε αν στη θέση της ήταν αντιεξουσιαστές ή αριστεροί παρά το γεγονός ότι η δράση της υπήρξε αυτό που αποτελεί τον ορισμό της τρομοκρατικής δράσης διότι ολόκληρες γειτονιές μεταναστών, ομάδες απεργών, διαδηλωτών και νεολαίων πραγματικά δεν μπορούσαν να κυκλοφορήσουν στο δρόμο τα χρόνια που είχε την αστυνομική ανοχή.
It's indicative that Golden Dawn is not prosecuted for terrorist acts, even though it is clear that their behavior all those years were the same as terrorism, and that for 3 years, while the police allowed them and gave them a free ring, that they went around beating people up and behaving like terrorists.
Η δίωξη της Χρυσής Αυγής στηρίζεται στο νόμο για την εγκληματική οργάνωση, ο οποίος είναι πολύ πιο επιεικής και ο οποίος από τα χρόνια εκείνα ήταν ήδη υποκατάργηση. Και αυτό το ήξερε η κυβέρνηση τότε και γι' αυτό της ετοίμαζε μια ελαφριά δίκη που θα κατέληγε σε καλό αποτέλεσμα για αυτήν.
Golden Dawn is prosecuted as a criminal organization. Is a charge much lesser than terrorism, and this is a conscious decision by the government that is preparing a trial for Golden Dawn that is going to go well, not as bad for them.
Ακόμα είναι χαρακτηριστικό ότι κατηγορούμενοι είναι τα εκτελεστικά όργανα για τη δολοφονία του Παύλου Φίσα, τη δολοφονική επίθεση ενάντια στους Αιγύπτιους ψαράδες και τη δολοφονική επίθεση ενάντια στους συνδικαλιστές του ΚΚΕ, ενώ κανένας από την ηγεσία και τους βουλευτές της Χρυσής Αυγής δεν αντιμετωπίζει κατηγορία ηθικής αυτουργίας, παρά το γεγονός ότι το κατηγορητήριο δέχεται ότι αυτοί οργάνωσαν όλες αυτές τις επιθέσεις.
It's indicative that the charges for the murders and the attacks are for the gangs of street thugs, and not against the MPs and the leadership of the organization, even though they were behind them. So the murder of Pavlos Fissas, the attacks, the murderous attacks against the communists, Egyptian fishermen that they attacked, all those are only for a few individuals and not for the leadership of Golden Dawn.
Αποτέλεσμα είναι ότι επί συνόλου 70 κατηγορουμένων στη δίκη αυτή, οι 25 μόνο κατηγορούνται για περιστατικά που έχουν σχέση με τις τρεις αυτές υποθέσεις. Οι υπόλοιποι κατηγορούνται μόνο για ένταξη ή διεύθυνση εγκληματικής οργάνωσης και ήδη πριν από λίγες μέρες απαγορεύτηκε στους δικηγόρους πολιτικής αγωγής να ασχολούνται με αυτούς τους κατηγορουμένους. Άρα, η ηγεσία της Χρυσής Αυγής δικάζεται χωρίς αντίλογο.
So, out of 70 defendants, only 25 defendants are prosecuted for murders in those three incidents. The others, the leadership, they are only there accused of being members of a criminal organization.
Μόλις την Πέμπτη, το δικαστήριο απαγόρευσε την τηλεοπτική ραδιοφωνική μετάδοση της δίκης ή τη βιντεοσκόπησή της, καθώς επίσης και την μαγνητοφώνηση των συνεδριάσεων, ώστε να διατυπώνονται τα πρακτικά εγγράφως με την απομαγνητοφώνηση.
Right, I forgot to say earlier that the prosecution lawyers are prevented for pursuing the leadership of Golden Dawn properly, and only recently that it was decided to prevent the minutes of the trial and the presentation of the trial in the mass media and the recording of what is happening at the moment.
Παράλληλα και η κυβέρνηση και η διοίκηση των δικαστηρίων αρνούνται πεισματικά να ικανοποιήσουν το αίτημα των συνηγόρων πολιτικής αγωγής ή δίκη να διεξαχθεί σε κεντρικό σημείο των Αθηνών και όχι μέσα στις φυλακές του Κορυδαλού σε μια περιοχή που απέχει μία ώρα από το κέντρο της Αθήνας και που είναι πάρα πολύ δύσκολη η πρόσβαση και η δημοσιότητα αλλά και η ασφάλεια αυτών που έρχονται γιατί είναι περιοχή που δρούν φασίστες της Χρυσής Αυγής.
The government and the authorities are denying the prosecution lawyers their demand that the trial should take place in a central place in Athens. At the moment, it's taking place an hour away from Athens in somewhere that is exposed to fascist thugs attacking people going in the trial, going in and out of the trial.
Όπως καταλαβαίνετε, κάτω από αυτές τις συνθήκες και με δεδομένο ότι το επίκεντρο της δημοσιότητας στρέφεται περισσότερο στις δραματικές οικονομικές και πολιτικές εξελίξεις που υπάρχουν στην Ελλάδα.
As you may realize is that under these circumstances, what's happening with the trial is taking the back seat, especially with the dramatic developments that are political developments taking place in Greece at the moment.
Οι φασίστες προσπαθούν να αρπάξουν την ευκαιρία να αθωωθούν, να ηρωοποιηθούν, να παραστήσουν ότι διώκονται για τις απόψεις τους και παράλληλα να αποτελέσουν εφεδρεία για τις πολιτικές εξελίξεις τώρα που μια αριστερή κυβέρνηση ετοιμάζεται να υπογράψει ένα μνημόνιο χειρότερο από τις προηγούμενες.
The fascists are trying to take advantage of the situation currently and present themselves as victims, being prosecuted just for their political ideas and trying to build on the crisis that is happening against with the new left-wing government and present an alternative and try and build using what's happening now in Greece.
Ο χρόνος δεν επιτρέπει μεγαλύτερη ανάλυση, παρά μονάχα να πω ότι το ποτάμι δεν γυρίζει πίσω. Οι φασίστες δεν πρόκειται ούτε στην Ελλάδα ούτε πουθενά να διαδραματίσουν κανένα ρόλο γιατί ο κόσμος τους έχει καταλάβει.
Right. Things are not going to turn back, though. Things have gone too far. They are not going to succeed. People know who these fascists are. They know them too well to be taken in. The time is limited to give a fuller analysis.
Όπως πολύ σωστά γράφει σε ένα άρθρο του στην τελευταία εργατική αλληλεγγύη ο Άλεξ Καλίνικος, η Ελλάδα έχει μία πολύ ριζοσπαστική αριστερά και εργατική τάξη.
Quite rightly, Alex Kalinikos has an article in εργατική αλληλεγγύη, which is the sister paper in Greece, saying that Greece has a very long tradition of left-wing militancy and a good left-wing organizations.
Αυτή είμαι βέβαιος ότι θα τσακίσει και τα μνημόνια και τους φασίστες και ότι στην Ελλάδα μετά το ΣΥΡΙΖΑ έρχεται η ώρα της ανταρσίας. Ευχαριστώ και συγγνώμη σας κούρασε.
Right, the left-wing movement in Greece is not going to allow the memorandums to get through, the crisis to just attack the working class. And after Syriza, the time for Andarsia is coming. Thank you very much.
Now I'd like to introduce the next speaker, who is Petros Constantinou. He's the coordinator for Kafaya, which has a stall over there, which is the movement against racism and fascism in Greece. And he is also a councillor on the a municipal councillor in Athens. And he's going to speak for about 15 minutes. Thank you.
Okay. I will share Kostas' optimism in the last words that he said. But before that, we have to be very clear that this is a very important period for the anti-fascists and the workers' movement to stop the neo-Nazis of Golden Dawn. I mean, moving in a period of deepening crisis with a left government, and after 5 months, we have already a big compromise in terms of this government was against austerity, and now they're pushing for a new memorandum, a new package of austerity. And you have Golden Dawn voting against that in the parliament. So they are pushing against themselves, even after of 2 years, when they were stopped, they were in prison. We have the starting of the trial, but still they are pushing that, okay, this was an accident. We are not Nazis. We are a political party against austerity. We are nationalists, we are Greek nationalists, and we are here. So this is a big battle that we have in front of us, and the importance of getting the trial as a political front of the anti-fascist movement, it's very clear for us. I mean, Kostas was describing how for a lot of years the fascist attacks came with the coverage of the Greek police, the Greek state. They had even the cooperation with the Party of New Democracy. Their general secretary of the government was in open line with the Nazis what to vote in the parliament. So it was very clear, all these connections. There are also connections between the Party of Golden Dawn and the capitalists, the ship owners especially. That's why we had the attack against the trade unions of the Communist Party in the area of Perama. They wanted to build a yellow union, a union for the bosses, and to smash the union of the workers there. So all these relations are still there, and we have to make sure that in this trial all these connections are open, and they will be convicted not only for the murders, but also because they are Nazis. This is the most important thing for us. They are not just an organization that makes some crimes, as all the other criminals. Their crimes are, you cannot explain them without seeing that they are a Nazi party. So this is what we want to make very clear for us, that we don't accept them as another political party. We don't want to give them space in the parliament, in the municipal authorities, in the streets, and so on. So the fight will go on, not only just to be present there, because we have to be present in the trial, supporting the family of Pavlos Fissas, the trade unionists, the fishermen who were stamped. So it's very important for us to have the workers, the mayors, the trade unionists, the immigrants, disabled people, gay people, to be there on the trial and be in solidarity with all the people who are standing in the trial. So this is what's happening in Greece the last 6 months. We built the movement. Kostas was describing what was happening with Golden Dawn before 2 years. What was really, it was that the presence of the anti-fascist movement didn't let them space. So the crackdown against the Golden Dawn meant that they stopped the physical attacks. They became, for a lot of months, almost to 0 point. So this was very important, that the immigrants can walk in the neighborhoods where they built their storm troops, and they were controlling a whole areas in Athens. That's very important now, that you can have all the space free and the immigrants working on the streets. But still, the problems are there. So we built this mass movement. CERFA was an organization, an anti-fascist and anti-racist organization, built in 2002 when the crisis was starting, and the ruling class was playing the card of racism, scapegoating the migrants especially. So CERFA was the auspice of resistance, supporting the migrants, organizing demonstrations locally, involving the trade unions in all these battles and so on. So when we come to the trial now of Golden Dawn and with the left government, it's very important to continue this united front. And it was very important for us that in the first day of the trial of the Golden Dawn, there was a mobilization on 20th of April, and condemned the murderers of Golden Dawn, the neo-Nazis, and the call was made by the Public Workers Union, the Union of the Sailors, the municipality of Korydallos, the area where the trial was, also the municipality of Nikia. That was the area where the storm troop, the gang of the fascists, started and murdered Pavlos Fissas, and student unions, communities of migrants. But most importantly, it's what is right here in Greece. That was a day of 4 hours general strike by the workers. And so for us, it's very important that we involve the trade unions, and they are ready to be there. We had that morning, 8 o'clock in the morning, in a remote area of Athens, a demonstration of more than 3,000 people. The first banner was the Public Workers Union. So for us, it's very important that we're involving all these people. You could see there Syriza members, Communist Party members. It was really a day of anti-fascist unity, and we practically prevented Golden Dawn to be there. And so we're controlling really the area out there. So for us, it's very important that we continue the campaign against Golden Dawn. And we take into consideration that things can change again. Even if they are in prison, even if they are in trial, all the things that are happening now politically can open them again, the space. So for us, it's very important how we continue this struggle. I said that we had with us Syriza members and Syriza trade unionists. But unfortunately, we didn't have the Syriza government with us. And this is something that worries us, because when we try to say, don't give the fascists space, we don't want the fascists to be equally treated in the parliament. But we had the president of the Greek parliament, Zoe Konstantopoulou, arguing that the Nazis who were in prison, the MPs, they should get the license for every meeting of the parliament, otherwise the decisions of the parliament are not legal. Of course, it was very important that this was not accepted by MPs, and they stayed in prison. But making this kind of statements is helping Golden Dawn, even in the trial, by arguing that, okay, we are a legal party. When you have President, the chair of the Athens prefecture, of Attica prefecture, giving them offices as a political party, that's again a problem there. So we need to to be sure that the fight goes on. And the other issue that is very important is that in order to fight fascism and to fight Nazism, you should open the fight against racism. And when you have Europe and the European police now, that means that the Mediterranean Sea is a cemetery, and we have hundreds and thousands of refugees losing their lives, women, children. For us, it's not acceptable that we have Dimitris Avramopoulos, who is the Commissioner for Migration and Citizenship, to argue that the solution is to close the borders and even to bomb the refugees, their boats in Libya. And this is something that was not opposed by the government. So it's an open front that we have to fight against racism and to go on and close the detention center, the concentration camps. So during the first days of a Syriza government, there were hunger strikes. Four refugees lost their lives. One committed suicide. Three of them lost their lives because of lack of medical care. And there was a revolt in the detention centers. And there was a lot of hope that these concentration camps, they would close down. They are still open. And there are still thousands of refugees in Lesbos and Samos now waiting for the process for them to get asylum. So there are still problems, and we want to open all these fights. In the last two months and the last week, there was a vote in the Greek parliament for giving citizenship for the children of the second generation. 200,000 children, they were born in Greece, and they don't have citizenship. So they voted a law that allows only half of them, under the condition that they will prove that they are Greeks by going to the school for 9 years, and not just going to the school, but to be successful in the exams. And also, their parents should be legal, and the child should have been born 5 years after they are legal. So I think this is not clearly a solution that the anti-racist movement fought, and there was a lot of resistance. The communities, they demonstrated, the teachers' union, they voted against that. So there are still open fronts to fight. So for us, it's very important that we keep building the movement, we'll use the trial of Golden Dawn to fight against the fascists. And of course, the most important thing is because of the economic crisis and the compromises of Syriza, we don't want to leave any space for the Nazis to push themselves as the opposition party. And this is very crucial and very important. And it's very important to relate with the workers' movement. It is very important to have a left alternative solution. And the Kerva movement in the last referendum took a position, a very clear position, that we are for no, we are against the austerity, and we intervene in the demonstrations there with the no stickers and leaflets, and arguing with the people why we should oppose this no, and to be very clear that this no against austerity and against the racism and against the Nazis, because against the Nazis are trying to put themselves as being part of all these movements, and really we didn't let them the space. But the stakes will be higher in the next period when there is the blackmail by the European Union, the blackmail by the bankers, and they want the left government to compromise. It's very important to have an alternative solution. An alternative solution of canceling the debt, nationalizing the bank under workers' control, getting outside of Europe and the European Union. So as an anti-fascist and anti-racist movement, we are part of all these efforts to have a strong workers' movement, but also a strong left solution. Because the most important thing that happened in Greece, and Kostas Papadakis was describing how the Nazis in the 2012, they were there. But don't forget that the immense majority of the Greek population, they went to the left. and we want this hope to be alive. This is the only way to get an exit from the crisis and not leave in even one space to the Nazis to win from that. We say never again of what happened with Hitler, and we have to make sure with the most organized way as an anti-fascist and anti-racist movement, but also by giving anti-capitalist alternative, that this will not happen this time.
Yeah, it's always good to be in the company of a good lawyer, because as lots of us anti-fascists know over the years, we do with them, so it's very good to be in good company. I think it, personally, I think it's, I always get a bit of a boost when I look at the Greek stuff, or occasionally have the pleasure and privilege to talk to people like Petros and hearing Despina and people talking about what's going on in Greece, because it fills you with hope at the same time as a horror, a golden dawn. And I think really Kurfa is a bit of a model for anti-fascists. We certainly in Unite Against Fascism, I'm sure abroad, we hold it up. You know, of course there's mistakes that Kurfa may make occasionally, who doesn't? But the work Kurfa's done, I think, is absolutely fundamental and incredibly, you know, you feel incredibly proud to be amongst and part of an international anti-fascist movement like that. Problem, of course, as I don't need to tell anyone here, is that even after everything, that the fascist vote still held up in Greece in January. They still got 17 MPs, obviously. Their vote was only 0.2% down on what it was just over three years previously. However, when you hear what's being done, it fills you, like I say, with hope and the politics to burst through what the Golden Dawn, who have clearly still got their core cadre membership intact, even after everything, even after the swines are still going through the courts and embarrassing pictures of them being taken, they're still clearly able to mobilise. And the other thing I'd like to say as well is from Kurfa, from Greece, that the March 21 anti-racist demonstrations were born internationally. And I know in Britain it's been important in terms of, never mind the fascists for a moment, but in terms of the sewer, the pit of rubbish and filth, racist filth that come out around the elections, the March of 21 demonstration was a small pointer towards saying there is an alternative to the bloody Tories, to Labour backing down, apart from people like Jeremy Corbyn, but Labour backing down to all the filth about immigrants and migrants and so on. And UKIP, right, the March 21 initiative came very much from Greece. I want to say one couple of quick things. I want to ask a couple of questions. How many police, I mean, it's supposed to be hard to tell, but it clearly seems that so many of the police are still, so many of the sympathetic Golden Dawn members in the police are still intact. You know, they haven't been weeded out. I don't know what Syriza's done. It doesn't seem that they've done much amongst everyone else they haven't done. But clearly still are many there at high levels, not just rank and file PC scum, so to speak, but clearly at many levels. And of course, what's happening in Greece, Every fascist and every anti-fascist and every revolutionary will be looking at Greece incredibly intensely. Of course, because of the anti-austerity fight and everything that people are doing against that. But moreover, when you look at Jobbik, a neo-Nazi organisation, the second major force in Hungary. Think of the history of Hungary, the deportation of Hungarian Jews. Poland, the Polish Nazis are trying to revive Le Pen as well. So I think what's happening in Greece is so important, it can't be overstated. And I'd just like to say one thing as well. In our humble little way, Unite Against Fascism has helped to keep the fascists here, alongside others, obviously, at bay. I'd like to ask people to join UAF if you can. And, you know, we stand on the shoulders of giants, us amongst ourselves. And I think, you know, the Greek comrades and other comrades, I think there's lessons we can learn there in terms of anti-fascism and anti-capitalism.
Last night in the Greek parliament, we saw a disgusting spectacle. We saw the members of parliament from Chrysi Avgi holding placards saying Ohi and grinning and laughing, while every Syriza MP voted yes. Eight had the courage to abstain. I think Zoe Kostandopoulou was among the ones who abstained. I don't know if Lafazanis abstained. Probably Kostas Lavavitsas abstained. So Golden Dawn is confident. They're playing another tactic. I mean, fascism always comes in two shapes. The boot boys on one hand, and the political respectable suit men on the other. I think since the murder of Pavlos Fissas, Golden Dawn was put on the defensive. However,
I think that they're rising partly because they've been rehabilitated, they've been brought into parliament, they look like other politicians, and also they did, I think, quite well out of the referendum campaign. They're just about the only force other than Darcia which are conditional. He says, okay. And it's interesting to note that in Lagonia and Peloponnesos, you know, which is the hub of reaction in many respects, there was a 51% majority for Ochi. I don't know, I hope I'm wrong, you know, but I get the impression that the defensive posture into which Golden Dawn was put after the murder of Pavlos Fissas has now cooled down, and they're actually growing in popularity as Syriza sells out. And if Syriza continues to sell out, then I think that support for Golden Dawn will increase unless we do something very drastic. I think what the comrades are doing in Greece is fantastic, but it's extremely difficult to fight the fascists when Syriza is actually undermining the collective fight against the European Union and demoralizing their own supporters. I don't want to end on a note of pessimism. I think that the spirit of resistance that we saw after the murder of Pavlos Fissas is what we have to hang on to. And neither do I want to telescope that Syriza will betray us and Golden Dawn will rise. That's not automatic by any means. It's up to us and what we do. But the situation last night in the Greek parliament made me want to vomit.
Yeah, thank you. I just wanted to pick up on the question of equivalence. The comrades talked about the pressure that there is to believe there's something equivalent between people who are fascists and people who are opposed to fascism. And I think that argument is an argument that's being played out everywhere where the fascists are on the line, and it's being played out in this country as well as anywhere else. And it is impossible to overstate the importance of exposing that and why and how anti-fascists are not equivalent to fascists. That they're standing on the base of democracy in order to smash democracy is fascism. And what we are doing as anti-fascists is fighting for that democracy. I think it's very important that we have this move against austerity that is coming up on the 4th of October. That's really after the summer holidays in this country. We've got tremendous example coming from Greece because of the history of what you did in terms of putting that marker down against racism and seeing that marker as the fight against racism as must go hand in hand with the fight against austerity, because it's the racism that justifies the austerity. So we cannot let that go for a second. And it's very important that we know here, and I hope that there are Greek people that will be with us on the 4th of October. The genesis of the TUC call for the mobilisation at the Tory party conference against austerity came from Unison, and it came from an emergency motion, and that motion was passed against austerity and racism. At this point in time, the TUC is calling for a march against austerity. Everything that we do between now and the 4th of October must foreground the argument that this goes hand in hand. We cannot talk about austerity without talking about racism. And I have just one question. You talked about there being an inhibition on the part of the media about reporting the detail inside of the trial. And I'd be interested to know what the grounds for that are, because that's the kind of mechanism that is, when it's applied, makes it possible for people to argue that there's an equivalence between fascists and anti-fascists, and there is not.
I think the experience in Greece offers a demolishing answer to the argument popping up here in front of the referendum, the EU referendum, argument presenting the EU as a counterweight to the rise of racism and fascism. Golden Dawn are political children of the leadership of the EU as well. Are political children of Merkel. It's not some kind of a conspiracy. It's not some secret plan. It was a political process. The pressure for more austerity made the political friends inside Greece, the main parties, using racism as a tool to control the movement. They created the political space for them. Kostas mentioned the rise of the breakthrough of Gondendone in 2012. Some months before that, they had, for the first time, a party with a fascist core, Laos, a party equivalent with a UKIP, had entered the government of austerity. They needed the fascists in a way to enter an austerity government. The collapse of that party, because of its participation in austerity government, opened more space for the eruption of for the breakthrough of Golden Dawn. It has been a process, and the European Union leadership is responsible for this process, offering the space to the fascists. Just to add to something the comrade just said, he's pessimist. Yes, okay. Last night it was disgusting. The Golden Dawn MPs raising the Ohi signs inside the parliament. But we know that the Ohi are not there, are not them. The Ohi are not them. Even the opinion poll showed that the Golden Dawn voters were the voters that followed less the line of their party. Many of the Golden Vote voters voted for yes to the referendum last week. It has been a left-wing vote for the Ohi, and this is something that we have won during this process of struggle. And that's the answer. That's why we can't be optimists, because the fight against austerity has never been separate from the fight against racism and all other fronts. This is an experience that is inside the movement, and they cannot break it. That's of course something that we have to go on working for.
Okay, after this comrade, there's a woman there with a pink top and blonde hair. She's next. Thank you.
Yes, I think the most important lesson which I learned from the speeches is that you have to have a combination between fight against racism and austerity. We had in Germany a big movement actually against Pegida. There is a meeting on this in this hall now, in the meetings here. And I think it was a wonderful movement against Pegida. Hundreds of thousands in many big towns in Germany went into the streets to stop Pegida, which is an anti-Islamistic movement, trying to grow from Dresden, where they were really strong, to go to Leipzig and to other big towns, and they were stopped, actually. They were stopped in Leipzig. This was very important, 20,000, 30,000 people going into the streets against them every Monday, and they were not successful to spill over, let's say, into other towns. So this was a victory, but at the same time, we have to see that the government pushes is anti-Islamophobia all the time. There is the Minister of Interior, de Maizière, gets up in television every second day to say there is a big danger of terrorism in Germany, and it's the Salafists. The Salafists are a big terrorist movement, and they are going to throw bombs around. Now, we had 180 murders from the right wing since 1990. We had an organization called the NSU, National Socialist Union, that's called. It's an illegal group which murdered over 10 years 10 people, and the police didn't do anything about it. There was a cover-up about them, and they are this sort of activities, terrorist activities, are taking place all the time, and it's supported by the government line that there is a terrorist danger of Islamism. And I think this is very important there for us to fight this sort of propaganda on the one side with a strong anti-racist movement. At the same time, we have to combine it with the fight against austerity everywhere, also in Germany.
Yeah, I agree with what the first speaker said, that it was an absolute travesty that Golden Dawn was able to wander the streets of Greece and commit the atrocities that they did. But the real question is, who's going to stop them? And it's certainly not the racist capitalist state.
And it's certainly not the Greek police that, as we've already spoken to, we know is absolutely rife with Golden Dawn sympathizers and members. I think we need to recognize here that, I mean, fascism, this is the reserve army used by the capitalists in times of crisis to smash the workers' movement. We saw this with the failure of social democracy in Germany and the rise of the Nazis there. A central obstacle currently is to a powerful united front movement is the illusions being pushed by the left in the democratic capitalist state. Most explicitly in Greece, we've got the SEK, and most of what we've heard here today from Kirfa and Antarzia is a call to jail the Nazis. Well, who are we asking to jail the Nazis? It's the same capitalist state, which is at bottom racist. Greece has a long history. We saw this in the Civil War of militant workers' struggle against Nazi occupation, in fact. And this is what needs to happen. There needs to be workers' defense guards organized at the head of a united front to smash the fascists. But to call for a classless movement from below, a mass movement from below, isn't going to be able to achieve this. Ultimately, what we need is workers' revolution, not Syriza. Syriza is a bourgeois government. We of the Spartacist League Britain said no vote to Syriza, and we said down with the EU, and we're for workers-led united front against fascism, and ultimately for workers' revolution.
Okay, after the comrade at the back.
2 points, comrades. The first one is our lawyers are very modest. I think we should sing their praises, because what they are doing is very brave and very important. The trial... the trial is happening in a bourgeois court, and the forces of the state are trying to make sure that some of the thugs will go to jail, but the leaders will get scot-free. And this is a huge fight. The fact that the lawyers are there for the prosecuting the Nazis is a voice for the anti-fascist movement in Greece, everywhere. Their arguments in the court will be a hammer that we use to make sure that the leaders of Golden Dawn go to jail along with the murderers of Pavlos Fissas. This is obviously a political fight, and this comes to the second point. The Golden Dawn are not in a position to benefit from pretending that they are supporters of the no vote. First of all, their organization actually supported the yes campaign. You all know that the Greek police in the general election, 50% of police officers voted for Golden Dawn. Now, in the referendum, 90% of police officers voted for yes. So the leaders may pretend that they represent the no vote, but the neo-Nazi followers, the organization and the voters are in the yes camp. This is something that we have to be clear. And the second aspect of this is that there was no room for Golden Dawn supporters to appear during the no rallies. Because the anti-fascist movement is strong, they had no ability to try and pretend they are supporters of OCHI during the open meetings and the open rallies. If they tried to do that, they would have been chased out by the anti-fascists. On the day of the referendum, there were stalls outside polling stations supporting the no, and the comrades were there. There was no polling station where Golden Dawn thugs had any ability to appear and pretend that they are supporting the no. They were completely isolated, and this is the basis for going forward. I think with every step that we take to show workers' opposition to the deal that Syriza is signing, we are isolating the fascists even more.
Comrades, I was very privileged in the January of 2003 to be in Athens when Kafa had a massive demonstration against the Nazis, and you actually got a sense of the stakes, even for somebody who was going over as a, you know, to march with the UAF contingent. You got a taste of the stakes out there. You know, just walking around Athens, there were squares that were Golden Dawn squares, you know, that matched the liberated squares of the left and whatever. That was very scary. What was incredibly moving was that a funeral march joined that demonstration. A young Pakistani man, 27-year-old Pakistani immigrant, had been stabbed to death by two Golden Dawn supporters, one of whom was a firefighter, you know, quite embedded in the state and whatever. It was, you got a real sense of the challenge that the Greek people had. And I think the tactic of the United Front that they've used is an example to the rest of Europe. And certainly, I wish comrades in France and anti-fascists in France would adopt that model, given the threat of the Front National out there and the rest of it. I wish it was being carried out across Europe, because we actually need that model of uniting with everybody who hates the bloody fascists and wants to actually smash them. I want to ask a question. I think I actually know the answer already, but I'd like the comrades from Greece to actually to flesh this out a bit. And that is one of the things that there was a roller coaster emotional ride when Syriza was elected. On the one hand, it was welcomed by any socialist should have welcomed the fact that an anti-austerity party was elected back in earlier in the year. But of course, one of the things that almost immediately got my blood boiling was that he went into an alliance with the Greek equivalent of UKIP, and now, you know. And the explanation we heard from actually people I think should know better, and I won't embarrass them by naming them, was, this is a great tactic, because what we've done is, because Greek workers vote for these parties, by actually making an alliance with this group, we are actually bringing those workers closer to us. Now, our argument has been never compromise on racism, not one millimetre, and I think that ran massive in Ambales. But what did that mean for the Greek anti-fascist and anti-racist struggle? Thank you.
Okay, I'd like Kostas to sum up and then... Thank you.
Από τις ερωτήσεις που έγιναν, ο χρόνος επιτρέπει να απαντήσω σε δύο. Η μία αφορά την ερώτηση μιας συντρόφισσας με ποιο σκεπτικό το δικαστήριο απαγόρευσε την μετάδοση της δίκης.
I have time to deal with two questions. The first from the comrade who asked on what basis did they decided not to allow the transmission of the trial.
Στην Ελλάδα λοιπόν ισχύει από το 2002 ένας νόμος που απαγορεύει την μετάδοση μιας δίκης εάν διαφωνεί έστω και ένας κατηγορούμενος ή πολιτικός ενάγοντας ή ο εισαγγελέας ή το δικαστήριο.
There is a law in Greece, exists since 2002, that even if one of the defendants complains and objects to its transmission.
Ο νόμος αυτός είχε ψηφιστεί τότε, διότι πλησίαζε η δίκη της οργάνωσης 17 Νοέμβρη και δεν θέλανε να μεταδοθεί για να μην ακουστεί ο υπερασπιστικός της λόγος.
That law was passed because the trial of November 17 was coming up, and they did not want the media to transmit their defense.
Παραμένει σε ισχύ όλα αυτά τα χρόνια, και παρότι η πολιτική αγωγή ζήτησε να μην εφαρμοστεί ο νόμος αυτός επειδή είναι αντισυνταγματικός, το δικαστήριο δεν επέτρεψε τη μετάδοση, διότι ούτε ο εισαγγελέας την ήθελε και προσέξτε, ούτε οι κατηγορούμενοι. Οι κατηγορούμενοι της Χρυσής Αυγής, συγγνώμη που σε ταλαιπωρώ, θα τα πεις σε περίληψη αυτά, οι οποίοι παραπονούνταν ότι η τηλεόραση τους αδικεί, τώρα που είχαν την ευκαιρία να μεταδοθεί η δίκη τηλεοπτικά για να παρουσιάσουν το πόσο δίκιο είχαν, αρνήθηκαν την πρόταση αυτή.
This law still exists. despite that it was argued that it's unconstitutional, the judges, and of course the defendants were very keen that the trial is not transmitted. They don't want people to know what is going on.
Το δεύτερο ερώτημα είναι πολιτικό, το έθεσαν αρκετοί. Γιατί η Χρυσή Αυγή εξακολουθεί να έχει ψηλά ποσοστά, γιατί ρώτησε ο τελευταίος ομιλητής, ο ΣΥΡΙΖΑ συνεργάζεται με τους ανεξάρτητους Έλληνες. Θα επιχειρήσω και σε αυτό μια απάντηση.
The second issue I want to deal with is how come the vote for Goldendon remains high. And the last question, the comrade asked,
γιατί ο ΣΥΡΙΖΑ συνεργάζεται με τους ανεξάρτητους.
How come ΣΥΡΙΖΑ is in collision with the independent Greeks?
Ξεκινάω πάλι με την αναφορά που έκανα πριν στον Άλεξ Καλίνικο, ότι η Ελλάδα έχει μια σημαντική ριζοσπαστική αριστερά και εργατική τάξη, για να πω ότι δεν είναι εύκολο να λες ναι στα μνημόνια, ακόμα κι αν είσαι δεξιό κόμμα.
I will start with quoting Alex Kalinikos that said, Greece has a long tradition of left-wing socialist movement, and that means it's not easy to say yes to a memorandum, even if you're on the right.
Όλα τα μνημονιακά κόμματα στην Ελλάδα είχαν πάρα πολύ κακή τύχη, από μείωση της εκλογικής τους δύναμης μέχρι διάλυση, και γι' αυτό το λόγο και στο χώρο της δεξιάς υπάρχουν κόμματα που μιλάνε με μια αντιμνημονιακή ρητορική, όπως είναι η Χρυσή Αυγή αλλά και οι ανεξάρτητοι Έλληνες.
What we saw in the last elections that the parties in favor of the memorandum lost votes. That means that some parties on the right, like Goldendon and the independent Greek, they have a rhetoric that on the surface argues against the memorandums.
Ο ΣΥΡΙΖΑ επέλεξε τους ανεξάρτητους Έλληνες γιατί έτσι πιστεύει ότι διασπά τη δεξιά και ταυτόχρονα δίνει εγγυήσεις στην αστική τάξη για την κυβέρνηση που ασκεί.
ΣΥΡΙΖΑ chose to go into collision with independent Greeks because arguing that this way is splitting the right and also reassures the ruling class about stability.
Και η Χρυσή Αυγή, όπως είπα και πριν, έχει μια λαϊκίστικη πολιτική, παρουσιάζει δημαγωγικά τον εαυτό της ως εχθρό του συστήματος, και πρέπει να λάβετε υπόψη ότι εξελίξεις όπως εχθές το βράδυ που αναφέρθηκαν πολλοί ομιλητές, δυστυχώς τη βοηθάνε. Όταν μην κοιτάτε που εσείς είστε μορφωμένοι αριστεροί, ξέρετε ορισμένα πράγματα. Ο απλός λαός όταν βλέπει ότι η αριστερά γίνεται μια συστημική δύναμη και τελικά ψηφίζει μνημόνια εκεί που πριν έλεγε όχι, είναι εύκολο να στραφεί προς τους φασίστες.
Goldendon is taking advantage. It's a populist organization, an opportunist. They are taking advantage of going on, what's happening now, and the fact that Syriza and what happened yesterday in the Greek parliament, lots of speakers referred to that, is a danger now that Goldendon can fill the gap and fill the vacuum and become more popular. It's not the same. The audience here, you are very political, you can see through, but for ordinary people, it's a danger that they might be taken in by these populist arguments, and there's a danger that Goldendon might actually grow out of what happened last night.
Σε αυτή την αντίφαση και σε αυτή την απογοήτευση επενδύει και η Χρυσή Αυγή, και γι' αυτό το ποσοστό της εξακολουθεί να είναι ψηλό. Έχει πέσει βέβαια, είχε πάρει και 9% στις ευρωεκλογές και έπεσε στο 6%, γιατί πολλοί κόσμος ακόμα παραβλέπει ότι είναι δολοφόνοι και τους ψηφίζει θεωρώντας ότι είναι αντισυστημικοί.
The popularity of Goldendon dropped from 9% to 6%, but it's still very high. Many people ignore the fact that they are murderous history, and they still have quite a lot of support because of this pretense that they are anti-establishment and this populist rhetorics.
Σε αυτό έχει μεγάλη ευθύνη και η αριστερά, όχι μόνο στην Ελλάδα. τα λάθη της ρεφορμιστικής αριστεράς, όπως και τα λάθη του υπαρκτού σοσιαλισμού, δυστυχώς τα πληρώνουμε όλοι, τα πληρώνει και η επαναστατική αριστερά.
The responsibility here, part of the responsibility lies with the reformist left, and we're all paying the price because they are not being clear, and we still have to deal with the threat of Golden Dawn.
Όπως επίσης, παραλίγο να πληρώσει ακριβά η αριστερά και στην Ελλάδα το ότι τα πρώτα χρόνια της δράσης της Χρυσής Αυγής μόνο η ΚΕΡΦΑ ήταν εκείνη η οποία ζητούσε ενότητα της αριστεράς εναντίον της και δεν βρίσκαμε δυστυχώς ανταπόκριση.
We paying this price, the revolutionary left, and what's been happening in addition that when GEFRA, the campaign in support of immigrants, when we first started, we were desperate trying to build up a united front and we were struggling to find others to come along and work with us.
Είμαι όμως αισιόδοξος τώρα, διότι υπάρχει και η πείρα και η γνώση και η διάθεση του κόσμου να αγωνιστεί.
I'm now optimistic because now we have more experience, we have learned from history, and people are prepared to take action and become more political.
Δεν υπάρχει άλλος χρόνος. Θα ήθελα να σας ευχαριστήσω και να σας πω ότι με συγκινεί βαθιά η παρουσία σας. Να ευχαριστήσω τον καθένα από εσάς. Δεν φανταζόμουν ποτέ ότι με ταυτόχρονη διεξαγωγή νέα meeting, πολύ μεγάλο ενδιαφέροντος, θα υπάρχουν πάνω από 150 άνθρωποι οι οποίοι βρίσκονται εδώ για να μάθουν τι γίνεται στην Ελλάδα.
The time is running out. I'd like to say a big thank you to everybody. Despite all the meetings that are taking place right now, it's over 150 people listening carefully about events and developments in Greece.
Θα μεταφέρω τη συμμετοχή και την παρουσία σας στη χώρα μου, τις πολύ εμπεριστατωμένες τοποθετήσεις σας που δείχνουν το ενδιαφέρον σας για την Ελλάδα. Και ζητώ και πάλι συγγνώμη που σας κούρασα επειδή δεν μιλάω τη γλώσσα σας. Ευχαριστώ.
Thank you very much. I'll take your interest and support back with me to Greece. And apologies that I had to have a translator.
Αν ξανάρθω, ελπίζω πρώτον ότι θα ξέρω αγγλικά και δεύτερον ότι θα έχω συμβάλει στο να καταδικαστούν και να πάνε στη φυλακή οι Ναζί. Ευχαριστώ.
Two things. Next time I'm here, I'm going to make an effort to learn a bit more English, but most importantly, I'm hoping next time I'm here that the Golden Dawn will be in prison.
Okay, first of all, I will also to thank the Greek lawyers, which are doing really hard job there in the prison, in the court, and so on. And to have lawyers that are supporting the victims without getting even €1, that's very important. That makes the campaign more difficult. But we have when you go to the room of the court, you can see that on the one side it's the lawyers for the victims against the Golden Dawn, and then you have 15 lawyers. On the other hand, when you have the Nazis, they have 120 lawyers. That's a lot of money, you know. That's a lot of connections with a big business, and they want to make sure that they will push the court on their side. That creates to Golden Dawn a big problem. They have to be good guys for 1 and 2 years. This creates nervousness to their military core, you know, who want blood. This is their life. They're Nazi criminals. And they cannot do it. And for a Nazi party, it's not the same as passing the time in a period of crisis. You know, if you compare the period of when the Nazis managed to control the situation, control power in Nazi Germany, they grew very rapidly. They used the storm troops, and they could give to their members the picture that were powerful, were growing very rapidly, and so on. What's happening with Golden Dawn? This is not a picture. Who is growing rapidly in Greece is the left. And with them, it's not only the left that is in the government, but also the capitalist left. And because the anti-capitalist left and the movement is working with the United Front, we don't repeat the mistakes that opened the space for the Nazis in Germany. We work with the trade unions. We work with all the political trends and all the people, unite them on the street, giving the possibility for the workers' union to fight against them. We're more powerful than them. Even if we don't have, sometimes the picture is coming from the TV and you can lose reality. Golden Dawn is only on TV. I mean, you just saw them with an ohi from the parliament in the TV. You cannot see them on the street. That's impossible. And we have to be very sure that this is the power of the anti-fascist, the anti-racist, and the workers' movement, and the left in Greece. We are not optimistic because we want to be optimistic, but we are optimistic because we built this unity, we built this movement, and that is why we demand more from Syriza, we demand more from the government, not to give them the space, because by giving them the space, they give them the possibility to win through a good decision from them, from the court, to go on. So that's why in the next period, when we have the Syriza government, we'll be on the streets, we'll be in the worker demonstrations and arguing there that we have to fight against the Nazis, we have to fight against racism. And I will end by calling all of you, and I'm very happy that we have comrades from different parts of Europe having this battle. CERFA will organize on 10 and 11th of October in Athens an international anti-fascist meeting. The last meeting called the International Day of Action. So we want to make sure that Marine Le Pen and her friends around Europe, they will be defeated also. We're a strong movement and we can win them. Hope is on our side and we have to make sure that really we win.